Good day, fellas. This is your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with the Leo Pata, the tank which balls got a bit cut, if I can say so. Pretty much what happened for this vehicle, they nerfed the gun characteristics in a way, right? I believe Kyler's is going to be some to do some kind of magic over there in the corner, and he will show what exactly happened for Leo Pata. And our mission is to test this tank out, and let's try to make this vehicle work. We are aiming for 4,000 combined. It's 2 in the morning, and let's see how this vehicle is going to perform, fellas. That's the goal, that's the plan, and that's the hope. Also, I believe quite some of you are interested, what the flying? Yeah, do we have in the O server, we have O3rd server? For now, fellas, yes, but remember, O3 server is added into the game, at least I think it's added into the game, not permanently, only temporary, because Halloween event is coming, and I believe quite some of you saw that teaser from Wargaming site, so keep this in mind, my lovely friend. Also, one more thing. Speaking about the Leo Pata. In my opinion, fellas, Leo Pata used to be one of the best medium tanks overall in the game, right? Speaking about the tier 9. So the question is, this nerf or mini nerf or however you are calling it, it nerfed completely Leo to the ground, or it's still valuable in the current meta? That's the question. And I believe, you know, there is many people which used to play pretty much non-stop with Leo because it's fun and because it's one of the best, right? This is the thing. Anyways, what we are going to do, we are going to go into the middle very quickly. Hopefully we are going to get into position in no time whatsoever and without any hit points taken, right? That's the plan. Speaking about the gun handling, it's still not looking that horrible. It is not looking like a big pile of kaku, you know, like it's impossible to do anything or something. The first thing which I said, the gun is not looking bad, and I am taking one for the team. Okay, what can we do here? Not much. I'm trying to escape before it's too late for obvious reasons, and Leopard 1 simply punished me for my stupidity and for my mistake. Hashtag never lucky. Not much what we can do about this. Relax, take it easy. This guy, he... Excusez-moi, fellas. How to understand this caco, huh? How to understand this abomination? Interesting. Okay. By the first look of it, fellas, enemies have shit ton of the forces which is playing around this area, right? But like shit ton of the forces. So what we need to do, we need to go up and we need to try to have a proper crossfire to the people which is playing over there. Let's try to help our team a bit. This is honestly not looking very good, but I can't change anything about that. We just simply need to carry on, right? Speaking about the good things. Hello. We are obviously banging the button in the side, and our team needs to go in. This is super duper hyper turbo important thing. Our team needs to go in, because if our team is not going to do that, we will have plenty, I repeat, plenty of troubles. Okay, look, as you can see, our lemming train is making a hardcore pressure here. This is exactly what we want to see, and this is exactly what we need. So let's go together with our team, fellas. Let's go together with our team. Meanwhile, this guy is tracked. We are making sure we are tracking him. He is dead, bloodyful. How about this Leo, Leo 1? He just shot. That's very good. How about if we would make a bit of pressure for this mother trucker? We are tracking him right here, which is very good. Too bad he managed to hit us into the face, but it doesn't change the fact he should be dead. Nice. Very good. So far, so good, fellas. We are fixing as many things as possible here, and we can't complain overall about this performance, at least that much, I would say. Meanwhile, Patton, sideways, hello. So once again, our main goal is going to be to save this E100 from the people which is playing around this area, right? And oh boy, they have plenty of the people which is playing right here. But I mean it, like plenty people which is playing here. And in fact, this entrance is looking quite blocked now. What do you think, fellas? Is this entrance blocked now? Nah, not really. Okay, I believe this is our last things what we can do in this battle. We are simply trying to get as many free shots as possible before going down. Because believe me, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we will go down. I repeat, we will go down. So speaking about this performance, I'm not entirely sure can I blame the tank itself. I don't really think it is a tank's fault in this battle, because what I asked for Leo is to hit a majority of the shots, and Leo did that when I fully aimed. And knowing this vehicle overall, this is completely fine, my friends. This is completely fine. This is exactly what this tank is all about. This is exactly what this tank is all about. You are hitting when you are aiming properly. If you are not aiming properly, then hashtag never lucky, and you are taking one for the team. This guy should be dead. Unfortunately, it's not the case. That's okay. Let's go towards him. Let's kill him like this. IS-7 is not very happy, and he is eliminating us from the game. So once again, it is completely fine what we have done right here. I am feeling like I gave my best, and as a test for Leopatai, it's not too much of the sniper schnitzel game. That was straightforward, try to kill enemies in the distance of 100 meters or less, right? It's okay. 3,300 damage. Funny fact, skill, what do you think, in what kind of place you are going to score in your team first? And I know it might look quite weird how you can be on top with a 3,300, but I think this is actually was the case. How enemies played this battle? They did quite good job. They cleared the heavy line, then they cleared the middle, and then they cleared everything rest, right? What was remaining. So yeah, good play for enemy team. Not much what we can do about this. So let's see. Let's see, are we top on the damage right here? That's the question. Actually, no, fellas, I'm second on the damage. It's still good performance. I am not complaining too much, and I am feeling quite happy about our tier 9 play, right? Good. Let's keep going, step by step, little by little, and let's hope for a bit better and longer battles, I suppose to say. Okay, tier 9, tier 10, tier 8 battle, right? So we are in the middle ground. That sounds like a plan. First things first. I believe we are going to play in the middle somewhere around this area. That's the plan. At least that's what I want to do. By the way, I noticed one thing. Some people said you can change the size of the maxi map if you are not showing the dog tags. So we'll see. Maybe it's going to be the case, fellas. Maybe it is going to be the case. First things first, we need to counter the person which is going to go like crazy in this position over there. I tried to shoot him, but unfortunately I did not manage it to hit this mother trucker. Now the question is Leo slower, or since I played with a light tank, it's just looking Leo is slow as a tank? Or maybe I don't have a top engine, maybe that's the problem. Weird. Very, very weird, my lovely friends. Extremely weird. Okay, patience is going to be important, and overall patience is going to be the key for us in this game. What do we want to see? We want to see this EBR going over there, right? This is exactly what we want to see, so let's wait for it. Progetto is trying to get into the bush, but we managed to punish EBR for quite a bit of the hit points, and he is down to one-shottable now. This is exactly what we wanted, and this is exactly what we needed too, right? Good. That's what we are looking for. Next, can we do something for this EBR when he's going to peek here? Sure thing we can. As you can see, EBR is dead, and Leo still can hit the shots quite well. At least I'm not complaining too much. Shots through the half of the map, 550 meters. Not a big problem, still a hit and still penetration, and still everything is looking quite Gucci right here. That was misaimed shot by me, fellas. My aim wasn't smooth as a button, right? Unfortunately. Okay. How about if we would make a bit of pressure towards this TVP which is sitting around this area? Obviously, if he's sitting over there, right? How we can check it out? Oh, Leopata, Bushwanker, Sniper, Schnitzel. He's running away for his life, but he took 450 in the face, which is always nice and always welcome. Speaking about the guys which is going to take one for the team, fellas. All their team is sitting in the middle of the shithole, honestly. I'm not joking, fellas. All their team is sitting in the middle of the shithole and they cannot change it. This is very, very, very bad situation for the enemy team. Speaking about the bad situation, I completely misaimed to shoot the GV Tiger, which is my fault. It is not a fault of the tank. And so far, honestly, I think this tank is literally the same as it used to be before. I did not play like 1000 battles with a buffed version of the Leopata, okay? I need to admit that, but I played quite a bit of the games overall. And I thought the tank was strong, I thought the tank is good, and you know what? I can say literally the same thing once again. I truly think Leopata as a vehicle is quite strong now. I think this tank have quite a good gun handling. And I think alpha damage is looking extremely, extremely well on this tank. Which is definitely the case, fellas. Which is definitely the case. By the way, do I have a sixth sense on this tank or I don't? Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, do I have sixth sense on this tank or I don't have a sixth sense? I just noticed that. Don't you dare to say I don't have a sixth sense. Don't you dare to say I do not have a sixth sense on this vehicle, because then it's going to be quite awkward and quite funny in the same time. Moment of truth. We managed to miss the shot and I am not spotted. Yep, I do not have a sixth sense. Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, someone of you said, skill mother trucker, we want some more equal stuff skill. We want some equal stuff. Here you go. Skill is playing without sixth sense. Is it equal enough, mother truckers? Is it equal enough, boys? Okay, I messed up. I forgot to train the sixth sense for my commander, which is understandable. It happens and... Who cares about the sixth sense anyway? It's overrated. Fellas, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, sixth sense is overrated. Okay, good thing we figured out that a hard way. We did not have the sixth sense, right? Now let's sixth sense, hip hip hooray, and let's get our self-situational of awareness, which is going to make our life just a bit better. Okay, here we go. Sixth sense, research it. Easy peasy lemon squeeze. So can we get a good game right here? Can the third battle be the best of those two which we played so far? Come on, let's see. Obviously, I believe it's quite clear the matchmaking which we are having nowadays, and I believe quite some of you are pissed off about that. It's 15-1 simulator or 15-5 simulator, however you are calling that. It's rare occasion when battles are actually equal, right? But this is not the first time, this is not the last time. We are living with this for like half a year or so. I believe everything started when EBRs came into the game. But once again, we cannot put only blame for EBRs nowadays. It's just not how the things is looking like. So, can we make a maximap bigger? Unfortunately, we cannot, even though we have the dog tags disabled completely. Shame. Oh well, what can we do? What do we want to do now, fellas? What do we want to do now? One more thing which I want to highlight, and I believe quite some of you did not notice it this. In this map, overall, this bush is completely nerfed. We used to have extremely strong bush in this area, right? You could pretty much sit here with a heavy tank and you wasn't getting outspotted. So what Wargaming did, Wargaming nerfed the bush a bit, right? So this is a quick information for every single of you to not get surprised about this. As you can see, bushes are way lower and it's looking weaker, but you can knock this tree down and now this is behaving like a bush, right? So we still can shoot someone from this area and we are still not going to get spotted. You will see that yourself. At least I think we shouldn't be spotted. Maybe I'm incorrect. We'll see. Time will show everything. So chill, relax, take it easy, grab yourself a popcorn, and let's hope this battle is going to be a tiny touch longer than usual 4 minutes of the World of Tanks, right? Plus, if it's not enough, I have a sixth sense. I have a sixth sense, boys and girls, ladies and gents. You know what is the weirdest thing? How I did not notice it this in the first battle. That was the weirdest thing for me, my friends. That was the weirdest one. Anyways, still waiting until enemies will make a bit of pressure. They have plenty of the heavy tanks. And speaking about the people which got spotted already, it is only 6 guns, right? If I'm not mistaken, 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. 6 guns got spotted, obviously. Art is sitting somewhere over there, so yeah. And once again, chill, relax, take it easy. Okay, what do we want to do? How about if we are going to take this position here and we will try to spot the Kapazander, which is sitting around this area. Kapazander is right here, good to know. He is in completely hold down position, which means I can't do shit for him. He's just sitting here and no one can do anything to this mother trucker, boys and girls, ladies and gents. Okay, fair enough. How about if we will cross like this and we will take this position right here? Maybe then we could find a decent angle from where we could shoot him right up the ass. And the answer is sure thing. That's definitely a dire hit for this mother trucker. Plus, on top of that, we spotted the Borat, which is trying to escape, but hashtag never lucky for him. Speaking about hashtag never lucky, fellas, I was thinking maybe I could kill Arta, and I definitely could kill Arta, but I decided not to. Why so? Because hitting Borat will bring us definitely way more use. Speaking about more use, if you would pay attention at the side, you would notice the Progetto, which is sitting in the open field right here, and what that means, it's time, it's matter of the time when he is going to get destroyed. I try to snapshot there, Hashem. Too bad I failed doing so. And once again, Standard B should be dead. Standard B is dead. Hip hip hooray. We are making a bit more pressure right here. We see the Kapazander sitting in the middle. Kapazander is saying noob team. And Kapazander is dying. Beautiful. What do we want to do now? Now we want to make a hardcore pressure for the enemies which is sitting around this area. Meanwhile, we are punishing the Progetto, which is trying to escape from his position. By the way, he was in the deep shithole before, so this is not a big surprise. He's getting slaughtered. And we already have 4,000 combined. Can we push a bit more and can we get like more assisting damage, more damage dealt, and then this battle is going to be the best one. Speaking about the score itself, it is casual 9-4, but overall I think we should finish this battle by having a casual 15-4, at least that's what I want to believe. Aiming for cupola shot, we are taking our time, and unfortunately, but we are missing. Although we cannot do anything about that, so what we are going to do now, we are going to flank this mother trucker, and flanking mother trucker is not paying off, unfortunately. Meanwhile, luckily he is not paying attention towards us, which is very good thing. And what I'm thinking about eliminating Mr. Borshik from the game, because he was extremely rude towards us. And now we are looking into the dead meat, and now all we need to do, we need to claim this 20 hit points over there, and maybe we can kill the trash burn, which is sitting next to the red line more likely. Am I sure about the trash burn over there? Well, I think it should be around here. But once again, that's only my prediction. This is only the guess. It's not 100% guaranteed. Speaking about not guaranteed, I was incorrect. Obviously, I guessed it correctly. Anyways, good. 5 points something thousand combined. Once again, I think I played very, very well. I think I did the things properly. And here you go. 20 minutes video, fellas. Crazy. Crazy what kind of situation we have. Remember those times when we needed like for 3 videos 30 minutes? Or over 30 minutes, not anymore. Here you go, 20 minutes power grind. 3.1 thousand damage, 2.8 thousand assisting damage. Top by the damage, top by the experience. Good performance by us, in my opinion. And in the end of the day, we are finishing everything with a Leopata. With a solid 3.3 thousand damage. And with 1,000 average assisting damage, which is bringing us over 4,000. And that's what I was aiming for with this vehicle, right? So it's not bad whatsoever. So the main question is, Skill, you mother trucker, you beautiful evil spirit, tell us, is Leopata destroyed? Is Leopata unplayable and Leopata is shit from now on? No. My lovely friends, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, it is looking literally the same Leopata, in my opinion. I think it is completely fine and I don't really think this nerf damaged this tank too much or something. I truly think this tank is just great and everything is fine with it. But feel free to share your opinion. What do you think about it? And maybe I am incorrect. Maybe I'm special. Maybe I missed something. Let me know in the comment section down below. Meanwhile, thank you so much for watching. And see you very, very soon. Skill is out. Peace, fellas.